Okay guys, this was a funny one. You see it's... You see how the glue has attached the cardboard fiber all around the insert. So man, this is a very long arrow, so I can actually take this one, cut it and use it on the... probably both the Centaur. And if I break it again, I can use it on the 58-inch Sky, so... But check that out, man! Doesn't it just belong here in the forest? That's what I love about these wonderful woods. Exotic woods in the Bowhands, because... Man, they come from the forest. And that is where I'm gonna use them. But check that crazy forest out, guys. Check that. This looks like there's been a storm here. And there have been several of them, so... But, well, you notice those close to a tree trunk are a bit hard, so we need to find something that is ace. Oh, there's a nice one. That is nice. Let's see. If we can find it. Where is it? Where is it? Ah, there. It's the grey one, eh? It looks like it's soft, so I pull the feather away. Check that out. Just between those trees, man. Let's see if we can put some arrows in there, eh? Low. Too low. But it goes so straight forwards. Dang, that's in the middle. It wasn't that soft, man, so I don't think I'm gonna shoot more. So guys, this thing about me saying I'm quitting YouTube, it was actually very, 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 very seriously done from my side, because the thing is that, well, most of you know that I kind of been out of work for over 5 years now, and well, you know, when we lived in Stockholm, they said that, well, if you're 35 years old, man, forget it. You're never gonna get a job in Stockholm. And man, I'm 50. Getting a job anywhere, it's like, it's not happening, eh? So. And it would be absolutely fantastic to be able to live by the bow, live by my archery, man. It was a dream, but so I thought that, okay guys, it's a long shot, but let's make it. So, and I really don't have any other options, so I tried to pursue that, but well, it didn't bone out, eh? And in a way, it's a good thing, because I can concentrate on really trying to get a normal job. But, yeah, me quitting YouTube with that film, that was serious, man. Because, I don't know, I kind of felt that I'd done so many films, and I mean, if I even couldn't get participants to my archery courses, man, why should I continue? But thanks to, I mean, all the amazing comments from you guys. What's there, like 250 comments, guys? And everything is positive. I think I just heard an owl. You can't really hear them, but something went right past me, man. Hope it was on the camera. So where was I? Well,
thanks to your comments, guys, it felt like, man, there's at least hundreds of them. And well, I got over 10,000 subbers, so yeah, there are a lot of you out there and actually enjoys my films. And in a way, I kind of enjoy this, having the camera, because in a way, in a stupid way, it feels like you're with me, because I don't know. Peter doesn't have that much time, man. He has his own forest. He has so much to do. And mostly I just shoot by myself. And that's also one thing that a guy asked me, like, don't you have like a queue of people wanting to follow you and go out shooting with you? But no, man, no one. No, I asked them. They don't want to. They don't dare to shoot. I don't know, man. So, okay, most of them don't speak English and they're afraid that I maybe put them in a spot that I have to speak English. And I don't know, but I think mostly it's just because they don't believe in their own shooting. I think it's just that simple, man. They don't think they can shoot that good. But man, if they just come along with me 5-10 times, man, we would bone that out, man. And they would be so much better, but no, they just want to. I mean, Peter, he didn't even hesitate, man. And I haven't taught him anything, actually. We're just going around shooting, and I'm just talking like I do with you about these things. And he's picking up things, but he was one of those naturals, man. He was good at start, from the start, but I don't know, man. My father always said, man, if you ever meet someone who's good at something, man, stick to him. Learn from him. Get good. Because he's probably done it for a long time and you can get a bit of a shortcut if you just listen to him. You don't have to learn for yourself for 20 years. Maybe it only takes 10, eh? So stop rumbling, Grady, let's shoot, eh?
I actually don't feel anything on my shoulder now, so, like that. Probably, maybe it is like I told you in a previous film, man. My shoulder needs me to shoot. Man, I have a funny one. You see the hat? I hope it's a stump pop. Let's take like a green hat. I hope that's on a stump. Can I put, now I'm getting cocky, eh? Can I put an arrow on that green stump and not the tree trunk? Ooh, bad release, went to the right, but I hit it, man. And it's a softie. That is not a softie. Come on, brain, you need to raise it 2 inches. Like that. Maybe even 3 inches, just stick twig laying on that. Yep. Now sometimes I just forget that I already shot 3 arrows, because it's fun, man. Yesterday I had 6 arrows, and oh man, I shot them all most of the times. See this SGHs, man? It's like, cuts like a knife, man. You know, one more thing that's good with the SGH is that there was this shot, like a stump like this, and there was a lot of moss behind it, and I'm gonna show you. Hey. I missed one arrow, so I start to think, man, I don't have a knife, I don't have anything to dig with. But you know what? The SGH is kind of perfect to dig with, because of the, see if I see anything. Ooh, wrong side of the sun. Because it has kind of, where are we? That was difficult to see. It has kind of a rounded backside of the point, is kind of rounded like this. So just dig with it, and even if it hits a shaft, It doesn't damage it, because it's soft on this end. So, and it was really easy to dig with. So, I don't know, just find kind of a, another good thing with the SGHs. I really love these points. Well, they break like anything else, because I don't think they they don't break as easily as all the other points do, but I eventually kind of wear them out, to be honest. So now we got nice ones here. We got one there and got another one behind it. And thing is that that one has rock and that is a stump behind it. So I know, man. Can we shoot them both? Let's try with the first one there. Oh, that went low. That was just a crappy shot. And another crappy error. I'm standing with my one leg up on the stump here. Really badly. Ooh. I really can't hit it, man. No, I got one arrow left. That was crappy. No, I didn't hit it, man. That's a magical stump, eh? Well, I don't know. Shall I just lift my hat? Well done, guy. Sick. But yeah, the trajectory is a bit different
than I'm used to. They go a bit lower, of course they do, because they weigh... What's this, man? It's a green knock. And I don't miss one. I probably dropped it or shot it off previously when I was here. But this is Peter's knock, so
yep. So I just told you in the beginning I'm gonna go shoot a few arrows, man. It's like yesterday, guys. I was out there for 1.5 hours, man, and I shot like 4 to 6 arrows every time. Check that out, man, there's some wonderful stumps. Oh, that's a nice one too. Well, there, let's take that one, see if I can actually hit it. So, okay, gear. Oh, there's a green leaf just in the middle of it. Good to concentrate on. Ooh, just on the left side of the arrow, man. Very, very close. And that was a soft. I hit it. And man, that's a soft stump. It went right through. Actually, what happened before here, guys, was that I didn't focus on anything because I couldn't really see. I just looked at the stump, then I missed it with 5 arrows. And that was like, what, 20 yards, guys? So, yeah, it's really that important to find a spot to look at. And now I'm at 4 arrows again, Gray. Get a grip, man. I don't feel anything. I mean, check that out, man. Now there's... Ooh, is it an old... Oh, it's a softy. But man, where's my arrows? I can only see 2, 3. And I shot 4. Wow, there it is. Ooh, it went far. It's a beautiful weather, man. Weather forecast said about 5-6 degrees, but I think we've got 5-8 degrees already. So you see the forest is it's just this small. What can it be? Is it 100 meters? Holy crap, there's a tree coming down there, man. Shit. It's a dangerous place, man. So I need to be vigilant so I don't get a tree trunk in my head, man. But man, I like the excitement. Is this safe? Okay, you who are not used to being in the forest, man, this is a bit crazy, because yeah, you should never risk your neck. But I'm almost born out here, man, so yeah, I know how to behave, how to be vigilant and awake if something happens. And I actually pan around me all the time when I walk, so I kind of know where to run if something happens. So need to think about that when you're in a forest like this. Man, there are trees that can fall down on you anytime. So I need to be sure that I can run and to run against or towards the right direction. Well, man, we got a holy smoke. But it's far away and there was something in the way there. But that would be nice to try out and see. Really bone out the trajectory with this. Oh, you see that one? I wonder if I can shoot it. See that? With a dark spot in the middle. But I don't know, that's so far. Oh, there it is. Yes. This is the Peter shot. Let's see if I can set up the camera so you actually see it. That would be good, eh? Yep, I need to raise the camera. I put it low on the... because I need to carry it over the tree trunk, so... let's elevate it a bit and see what we can do. Can you see it? It's over there. If I do a bit like this, see if you can get me in the picture too. The LCD screen is actually leaning against the tree trunk here. I hope it doesn't break it. So. Okay, now I got one advantage here. It's downhill, so ooh, the trees are complaining, man. I don't think I want to go here if it's really windy. So where is it, man? There. There's some twigs in the way, so I'm probably gonna hit some twigs. They're like. Ooh, two different places, man. So. Man, I think I hit the exact spot I was looking at. And it went right through. It like butter, man. I think I need to shoot lower down because it's so soft, man. And I just wonder. It's all that bad release. Bad release. Bad grain. Oh! And don't you just hate that? Don't dare to shoot anymore. You see that? Dang! Sometimes that happens on the first arrow, man. How fun is that? You see my arrow lace? Man, if I shoot another arrow, I bet you I'm gonna break that arrow in half. But guys, I mean, I didn't feel anything, like the bow went lower. Maybe I just have the wrong pressure point sometimes, so I kind of point them arrows lower with my grip. That's something that can happen, actually, if you kind of both upwards and downwards, because you just have kind of just have a bad grip. Pressure point is in the wrong place. It's not in the deep throat of the grip, so it's altered your up and down shooting. What's the best way to go there, man? Ooh, man, I just realized something. I could have problems finding my arrows that went through, because... Ooh, do you see that? No, I should be, because I'm shooting from upwards position down. So, yeah, here they are. Three arrows. Two in it. One right through. There it is. So, guys. Oh, talking about long shots. Check that out. I had to take it. I really have to take that one. You see there. Oh, dang. Oopsie boops. Almost destroyed my camera, guys. I hope you don't get seasick easily. I'm really moving that camera today, eh? So, can I hit it? If I would estimate yardage on that one, it's like, well, it's close to 50 meters, man. So, let's see what happens. There actually is a light brown something in the middle of that stump for me to look at. So. Man, it's in this stump. Because that is actually something that happens when you've been shooting for a long time. The brain adapts so quickly, so fast. Now this is a typical example of that, man. It's like my brain already adapted itself to the yardage difference between these, well, it could be over 9 GPP arrows to my 8 GPP arrows. And I knew that one's gonna go over and I still released it. You recognize that? But man, that was a soft one too, behind it. That went low, but that was just my bad. Oh, dang, that was the worst of releases, man. So, how do we get there? Colandrol. Is that a bit of a colandrol? What's the word I'm seeking? Hey, and the game I mentioned, Pluck a Pin. If you know what I mean, what is it called in English? Please comment. Where is it? There. Stump. Run and hide, I can find. Oh, it's starting to pick up the wind, man, so I think I need to leave this forest. The big one behind it was soft, man. It felt like cardboard. And it's a bit chilly, I can tell you that. It's a humid forest, and well, it's not more than, what is it? 10:30 in there. 10:30 a.m. something like that. So the sun haven't been really heating up anything yet, so man, there's a path here, let's follow that. That's a nice one, eh? But it's too close, man. And that is so good to do. Challenging yourself. Don't take those easy shots only, man. Try to do those difficult shots. I just wonder if this is... Is it going to be rock hard, guys? Just one there. It looks a bit strange, so...
Let's test it with one arrow. Man, and that arrow... is gone. Dang, that was number two. It's gonna be an expensive trip this, eh? But these are my old arrows, man. I should take out the insert and glue them again. These are glued like 1-2 years ago, so... And even the hot melt glue kind of gets brittle, guys, so... It could be a good idea to... re-glue the inserts if the arrows are like glued last year. Last season, so... If you're stumping. I mean, so... Let's see what it does. Oh, man. Oh, I don't like that sound. And that's a long shot, man. Just a bit low on it. Eh? But the sound... Ooh, you know that cracking carbon fiber sound. I hope it was the wood. I hope it was the wood. Yeah, thankfully. Days like this, probably good to have a three-armed point. Check that stump out. Man, it is an amazing forest, isn't it? That's my arrow. I came from that way before. So, man. I think I can put an arrow on that mossy tree trunk there. Let's check it out, if it goes right through, or if I can. Yep, I can. And I don't know if you can even hear the bow, because it is so quiet. I don't know how the man does it, man. But he does it rather well, as they say in English. Ooh, here, man. That's a nice target. That's gonna be gone next time I'll be here with Peter, eh? But it's a beautiful, fantastic piece of forest, guys. I don't know, it's so pleasant to be here. Oh, no. This is so typical too, when you're heading back home, you see things like that. All the good ones are behind you, eh? But man, there's an arrow sticking up on that stump. There's a big rock behind it too, don't like that one, but hey. Can I do something with that arrow, man? Let's zoom it in. Can I shoot that off? Well, I'll be a fool if I didn't try, eh? Just down low where it sits on the stump. I can now with the first arrow, and ooh, that felt so good. Oh man. I mean, this is a love story between me and this little bow. Thunder child, I'm just... I mean, can you be in love with a bow, man? I'm head over heels.
And you know,
I there's really nothing that told me that this could be this good. Other than the comments of others, and but I don't know them. I don't know what how they are as an archer, but now I know they are real good and they know what they're talking about. And Jim, my man, big Jim, take a bow for you, guy, for you, man. Incredible bow you made. I'm so blown away. It's so fantastic. It's so easy, smooth, fast, short, nimble. And when I just get to know her better, man, and I don't do these crappy shots. Shot, bad releases, man. I am going to nail everything I look at with this one, cause sick, it's, I mean, this is a mind blow. This is how bows should be, man. I mean, just imagine the feeling when you order, you get your hands on something like this, comes home to you, it's yours. You string it, you put on an arrow, and bang, smooth, fast, wonderful, no recoil whatsoever, man. And then you bare shot it, you go out and you just continue banging those arrows wherever you look at, man. Oh, man. That is what archery should be. That feeling is what a bowyer should give you by making good bows. And man, these bows have been reviewed. It's like every one of them has something special, a bit different. And but I don't know, this last one, I think this is almost the biggest mind blow, because I just, if anyone asked me